Power Automate seems to be a really hot topic these days, and you may be wondering, how does this tool apply to the work that I do every day and what's in it for me? Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. My name is Heather. Today I'm going to walk you through a use case where you can use Power Automate, Forms, and Outlook to automatically process the responses you receive from forms and send an email. This flow can be built by anybody with out-of-the-box tools provided by Power Automate, even if you have no computer engineering or coding skills like me. So let's jump on the computer and learn how to build this flow together. To create this flow, you're going to go to office.com, select All Apps, and then choose Power Automate. From there, I'm going to select Create, and we're going to want an automated cloud flow. The scenario we're going to cover today for this use case is that we have received a forms response for a customer satisfaction survey. The person who submitted the survey will automatically get a follow-up email, and if that person said that they were very dissatisfied with the class, the organizer will automatically be notified. Let's get started and give the flow a name. If you don't provide one, Power Automate will automatically assign a generic one. And we're going to choose the forms trigger for when a new response is submitted. And then click Create. For the form ID, you will need to tell Power Automate which form you are looking for responses from. If you click the drop-down, you will see forms that you've created in the My Forms section. If the form you want to use happens to be a group form, you will need to get the form ID. To do that, you will go to Forms, and at the very end of the URL, you will see the form ID, which you will copy and paste into Power Automate. I do have a quick tip video on that if you need to see how that is done. In this case, I'm going to simply select the customer satisfaction survey form. Then I will select New Step. And I'm going to need to save forms. And I'm going to get the response details. The reason we want to do this is so that Power Automate can extract the information from the form that was submitted and use it in the following steps. We will need to click the drop-down next to Form ID and select Customer Satisfaction Survey again. And then we need to get the response ID. The next thing we're going to do is select New Step and search for the email connector because we want everyone who submitted a response to automatically receive an email with any follow-on information from the event that they attended. I will select the Office 365 Outlook Send Email V2 action because that will automatically connect to my business email address rather than a personal email address. Now we will start crafting the email and we will use dynamic content to determine who the email should go to. Because my form is not anonymous, it automatically gathers the responder's email address, which I can use to put in the two lines so that Power Automate will automatically send an email to whomever submitted the response. For the subject line, you can enter any title that makes sense to you. In the body of the email, you can build your customized message to send back to the person who submitted your customer satisfaction survey. For the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to keep it relatively simple and just put in a thank you message and one link that contains information discussed in our hypothetical event. To add the link, highlight the text, go to the link icon in the toolbar, paste in the link, and then click Add. The first part of our flow is complete, and the customer is going to receive their automatic email. Now we need to build the next part of the flow, where if the customer said that they were very dissatisfied with the event, the organizer needs to be notified. So in order to do that, what I'm going to do is I'm going to click this plus sign in between the steps and add a parallel branch. And then I'm going to add a condition control. What this allows me to do is add the dynamic content of how satisfied were you with the event you attended. And then say if the answer is equal to very dissatisfied, I need to notify someone. One thing that is important to note is this field is case sensitive. So because very is capitalized on the form, it must be capitalized in Power Automate as well, or the condition will not evaluate correctly. Now let's add an action to tell Power Automate what to do if the condition evaluates as yes. I'm going to send another email by using the Office 365 connector again, but this time I'm going to say it needs to go to the organizer. For the sake of simplicity, I am going to send the email to myself. Again, a subject line is required so you can enter anything that makes sense in your particular business scenario. I'm just going to say that the event's response requires attention. You can put as much information in this email as you need to. I'm intentionally keeping it simple for the purposes of this demonstration. In our scenario, if the person is not dissatisfied, we don't need to do anything, and therefore, the if-no side of this statement is going to be left blank. Now it's time to save the flow and test it. I'm going to go to the upper right-hand corner, select Test, and select Manually Trigger Flow, and then click Test again. Now I will go to my Customer Satisfaction Survey, and I will say I am very dissatisfied and enter some comments. And then hit submit. You will get a message saying your flow ran successfully and there will be a green check mark next to every successful step. If we go back to my email, keep in mind that I'm not only the person who submitted it, but I'm the organizer, so I received both emails. So the first one was thanking me for submitting my response, and then it gives me a link to the training homepage. And if I click on it, it took me to the SharePoint site associated with the training event. And the other email I received was the very dissatisfied response, and it pulled in the dynamic content of the exact comments that I made, as well as the email address. So now you can see that the flow did in fact work as we intended. And now we have completed our flow. I hope this use case has helped you to understand how Power Automate can help you solve business challenges and save time. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.